Hello, you're watching Scorecard Ents, and today we'll be looking at the lighting system in the Boeing 777. So first we'll have a look at the external lighting controls. The external lighting controls are found on the forward section of the overhead panel. These lights can be turned on and off using the push buttons found here. So it's beacon, navigation lights, logo light, and wing inspection lights. Next, the strobes can be turned on using the switch here. And the same for the taxi light. The runway turn-off lights can be turned on and off using these switches here. And if middle clicked, both switches can be moved simultaneously. Finally, the left, right, and nose landing lights can be switched on individually, or they can be switched on and off simultaneously, again using the middle click. The flight deck lighting controls are located in a number of positions as indicated. The master brightness control allows the number of lights and displays to be controlled using a single switch. These include the 6 LCD display units, the 3 CDUs, the 2 clocks, the standby instruments, standby compass, digital displays, overhead panel, glare shield panel, forward panel, and aisle stand. The master brightness control switch is located on the forward section of the overhead panel. The master brightness control can be switched on and off by pressing the button in the middle of the switch. The master brightness can be adjusted by rotating the knob using the center scroll wheel of your mouse. The rotary brightness control switches for most lights and displays have a centered dot detent. By positioning the switch to this detent, the master brightness control switch will have maximum authority over the brightness of that light or display. For example, the backlighting of the overhead panel and circuit breaker panel can be adjusted using the outer knob of the overhead CB switch. And can be repositioned to the center detent by using the middle click. Minor deviations from the brightness commanded by the master brightness control switch can be made by positioning individual light switches left or right of the center detent. When the master brightness control is off, each switch has full authority over the respective light or display. To control the overhead panel backlighting, rotate the rotary switch as shown. To return to the center detent position, middle click. To adjust the circuit breaker panel lighting, rotate the inner knob. Underneath the overhead panel and circuit breaker panel lighting switch is the glare shield panel backlight and floodlight switch. To adjust the panel backlighting, rotate the outer knob. And again, center click to return to the center detent. The floodlighting is adjusted using the inner knob. dome lighting can be adjusted using the dome light switch. In this simulation, there are only three positions: off, medium, and full. The storm light activates the dome light and turns all lights and displays to full brightness, overriding any existing settings. Finally, the indicator lights test can be activated by moving the switch to the aft position. This turns on all lights and sets all digital displays to their test pattern. The indicator light switch can be set to bright or dim by positioning the switch in the appropriate position. The controls for the ICAS and MFD brightness are found near the MFD. The brightness of the displays can be adjusted simply by rotating the appropriate rotary switch and can be reset to the middle detent by middle clicking. On the outboard side of each crew member position, there are five brightness control switches. The first switch controls the outboard display, or PFD. Brightness is adjusted again by rotating the knob and middle clicking to reset to the center detent. The inboard display brightness is controlled by rotating the outer knob. This too can be reset to the center position by middle clicking. The terrain display brightness can be adjusted by using the inner knob. This knob cannot be reset to the center position using the middle click. This switch can also be reset to the center position by middle clicking. Finally, the instrument panel backlight can be adjusted by using the outer knob of the last switch, and the flood lighting adjusted using the inner knob. A similar configuration exists on the first officer side of the cockpit. The last lighting control is on the aft section of the aisle stand, and this controls the aisle stand backlighting and flood lighting. The outer knob controls the backlighting, and the inner knob controls the flood lighting. So this concludes the video tutorial on the 777 lighting systems. If you have any questions, feel free to post them in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you next week.